Hi everyone, I'm JD Hillberry. One of the main questions I get in my workshops is how do you get the basic proportions down correctly when you're trying to do an extremely realistic drawing? Now, no amount of shading can make a drawing look realistic if the basic bones or the structure of the drawing is not down there correct. So in this video, I'm going to show you a few tools and techniques that I use to get the proportions down very accurately, which will really help in your drawings. You may be already familiar with this grid method that a lot of people use like this. The problem with this is you end up with a lot of these vertical and horizontal lines all over on your paper, which can be very difficult to remove. And it's very tedious to put down in the first place. My favorite method for getting proportions down when working from a photograph is a variation on this grid method. It's much simpler. It doesn't use all of those lines all over. You end up with just vertical, horizontal, square, and diagonals. The other thing I use with this is a compass. Most people are used to using these for drawing circles. That's mostly what they're used for, but it makes an excellent measuring tool. This particular compass comes with a little pencil, but you can also take this pencil out and put in other pencils that might be more appropriate for your drawing. This is the layout pencil that comes in my kit. When you're trading pencils out, make sure that the point and the end of your pencil is even. Snaps into place like that. The other pencil that I like to use with this compass is the F graphite pencil. It's a little bit lighter than the layout pencil, and sometimes it's exactly what I need. The other thing I'm going to show you in this video is a proportional divider. This is also available on my website now. This is a really handy device. I use it just like the compass, except you can enlarge with this instead of drawing the same size as your reference photo. You change the distance between the points by taking out the centerpiece and moving it to a different hole. Slip this back in here, and you can see the distance between the points on this end is much smaller than the other end. You'll take measurements from your photograph, turn it around, mark those points on your drawing paper to enlarge it. Again, it's very easy to change. You can adjust it to where it's just a ratio of 1:1, so it ends up being just like the compass. You can order these on my website as well in my bonus package with my pencil kit from the link below. So the first thing I'll demonstrate here is that grid method, if you're not familiar with it, and show you some of the advantages and drawbacks with using it. It's basically a lot of little squares or a grid pattern all over on your reference photograph. And I'll show you really quickly here what this is all about and give you several other different ways to get your proportions down that I feel are much better. A lot of people number and letter them so you don't get mixed up on which square is which. You can just use a ruler to draw these squares. These are half-inch squares. It's best to use a pen that doesn't smear if you're going to be drawing directly on the photograph. Some people also get a clear piece of plastic or even glass and draw the grid pattern on that glass rather than directly on the photograph. So after you have this pattern on your photograph, the next thing you do is put the same number of squares or the same grid on your drawing paper. So I'll just show you a little bit how this works here. Let's say I want to figure out the side of his head over here. So I look over there at the number 4 and look at where it crosses that square, and then where it crosses the next square over by 3 there, just judging where these little points cross each little square. This helps divide your drawing up into tiny little pieces and can make it much more easy to manage that way. You would do the same thing for drawing all the details. For instance, this eye here is over here on F and 4. So looking down, I can see the corner of his eye is right around this area. So that's the basics of how you use this method that a lot of people are familiar with. Now, if you want to enlarge your drawing, you do the same thing, except you draw the squares on your drawing larger than the ones on your reference photograph. So you can see where I've drawn the edge of his head here, and it is twice as big. The problem becomes your drawing ends up with a lot of squares all over it that you're going to have to erase. This can be very tedious and very time consuming and really kind of take the fun out of drawing. The worst part about it is there's so many squares to erase. You'll have to try to erase around everything that you've drawn. If you don't erase completely, you can see a little hint of these squares all over on your drawing. If you like this grid method, I'm not telling you you shouldn't do it, but one of the things I would suggest the next time you try the grid method, if you want to stick with this, don't put as many lines on your photograph. Instead of making them half inch, maybe make them an inch the next time, or even 2 inches. You can wean yourself off of this grid a little bit, and that will help train your eyes to see angles and distances better. And you won't have as many lines to have to erase. The modified grid pattern that I use doesn't have nearly as many lines. There are 21 lines all over on this reference photograph. My modified grid pattern will have just 8. So we have to start off by putting this pattern on the photograph. First thing you want to do is crop your photograph very, very closely to your subject, so the edges come in contact with some of the key parts of your subject. The next thing I'm going to do is put a diagonal line right through there with this pen. And I'll do a diagonal line going the other direction. And now I want to take a measurement where the halfway point is and draw another line that goes across horizontally. It should go right through that X in the middle. I want another line right down the middle there, so I'll do that from top to bottom. Now that I have the horizontal, vertical, and diagonal lines in there, I want to transfer those onto my drawing paper. So I'm just drawing around the outside of the photograph using either my F graphite pencil or a layout pencil. And then by doing the same thing I did on the photograph, I'm going to put all of those lines very lightly right on my drawing paper there. The next thing I want to do is line up this photograph with the lines on the paper. So it's right next to these diagonal and vertical lines here. And then I'm going to get a compass. It has a pencil on one end, so it can make a little dot once I get some measurements down there. It can really speed things up quite a bit for taking accurate measurements. So let's just start off on the side here. I can find out where the edge of his head is there on the right, and down here on his chin, how far up his chin is. I can just make a little landmark right there with the pencil. You can double check these from any other reference mark you have on the photograph. Measuring from the center, I can see that that mark was correct. Now I want to put the detailed proportions in there as well. So I want to get the basic outline of this eye on the left here. So I'm just going to take a measurement from the center axis down to the edge of his tear duct here. So I get that, I'll make a little dot on my paper and I'll know that's right where that tear duct is. I can use the diagonal lines to figure out how far down his eyelid is. And once you have your reference marks all around there, then you can start drawing, or you can actually do reference marks and draw as you go. It doesn't really matter how you use this, but it really can help get your drawing down there much more accurately without putting lots of grid lines all over your paper. Now, since you do have some of these lines, put them on lightly so you can erase them later. So I just use my kneaded eraser and I can back out these lines. So once I start shading, those won't show up through the shading on my portrait. So this is a great technique when you're using a reference photograph that's the same size as your drawing. Now I'll show you how to use this modified grid pattern with the proportional divider to make your drawing larger than what your reference photograph is. First thing, let's mark the corners of the smaller photograph. Now that I have these little dots on there, I want to draw that pattern that we had, except I'm going to make it larger. Draw my lines right through these corners. This is in the fourth hole up, so it's going to enlarge this 1.5 times the size of that photograph. So using the small end here, I'm just going to take a measurement from that center line to the edge of the photograph, flip it around, and make your little dot. That's going to be the edge of your rectangle. The same measurement you can use to get all four corners of the rectangle. Next, just take your ruler and connect the dots. If you want to, you can erase any place where the diagonal lines were too long. You could have also measured how long you want to make those diagonal lines, and you wouldn't have to be erasing here. Now I want to line up the photograph right next to where I'm going to draw it here. Now I can start taking the measurements. Let's just measure from the center point out to the edge of his hair, flip the divider around, line it up, and make a little dot right where that curve is, right there. One of the reasons I like to draw this rectangle around the image, because it helps me see negative space better. It's easier to draw this shape than the shape of his head. I see that this is halfway in between the top and my center line. So I think that's going to start about right there is where the edge of his hair is. It kind of goes up over here. Then it has to go down, right, swoops down by the diagonal line. I want to visually divide that in half. And visually divide this in half over here. It's where that hair starts to come up. Then it swoops down towards the diagonal. Then back up again. Now I could measure every tiny little thing in here to get it perfect, but I'm training my eyes to see angles and shapes better. And since I have the diagonals and the verticals and the horizontal lines all on there, it can really help me see angles and shapes much better. Now, you can use this method to just double check your measurements as well. So I want to look here how wide his nose is in my reference photograph. Flip over the divider. That looks about right. Let's check the width of his eyes here. Make sure I had that correct. Flip this around, and I see I have the width of his eyes correct. So this is a great way to double check when things aren't quite looking right. If you just want to draw freehand and don't want horizontal or vertical or diagonal lines in there, you can use this proportional divider to help you double check your work. Hi again. I hope this video helped you get a better understanding of how I get the basic proportions down in my work. And if you're interested in the compass or the proportional divider, you can click the links below this video to go to my website and find out how you can get those. And please feel free to share this video with anybody you know of that might be interested. Thanks. Bye.